Hello and welcome to an introduction to reaction types. There are many types of reactions in chemistry, and any introductory text will usually present these five types of reactions. In this video, we will look at what characterizes each reaction type so that you can identify each type of reaction. Placing reactions into categories can be very helpful when you are doing a reaction that you are unfamiliar with so that you can predict what might happen, or it can help you design a reaction to get a particular outcome. Identifying a reaction type helps you to predict products, and the second part of this topic you will find in a series of links to videos on how to predict products. Our first reaction type is called combination/synthesis. Synthesis is a much broader term than combination, so we will stick with just combination. Basically, we are combining atoms or molecules to create a new molecule. For example, zinc and sulfur combine to produce zinc sulfide. For each example, we will make a model for the reaction type, and importantly, find a feature of the chemical equation that tells us the reaction type. For combination, the model is simply two substances represented by A and B, combining to produce a single product made up of A and B, which is represented by C. So very importantly, we can identify combination reactions as having a single product. Another example is hydrogen and oxygen combining to make water. Notice it is not balanced, and for the sake of brevity, we will not balance any equations in this video. We can see that these reactions have only one product, and that identifies them as combination reactions. So two substances react to form one product. Second reaction type is decomposition. In the example, hydrogen peroxide decomposes into two substances, oxygen and water. The model is a single compound breaks apart or decomposes into two substances, and the identifying feature is seeing that there is one reactant, which breaks apart into component substances. Another example is the decomposition of barium carbonate. We see in the equation there is one reactant which decomposes into component elements and/or compounds. Click on this link for predicting products and decomposition. The third reaction type is combustion, including hydrocarbon combustion. Let's look at the model and identifying feature first, and leave out hydrocarbon combustion for now. We see in the model that oxygen is a reactant, and that is what identifies a combustion reaction. In particular, this is a rapid reaction with oxygen that would constitute combustion. There are many reactions constantly occurring all around us and in our bodies that are substances reacting with oxygen in the air or in our cells, but these are not combustion. We would notice combustion immediately because it gives off lots of heat and has a flame. In other words, fire. Fire is another word for combustion. One example is iron. At high enough temperatures, metals will burn. Another example is the combustion of hydrogen to produce water. Notice that both of these also fit into the category of combination. So oxygen is a required reactant, and what is reacting with it is called fuel, a common word we use with any fire. However, any fire that we may see in our everyday lives is almost exclusively a hydrocarbon combustion. So let's take a look at hydrocarbon combustion. We still have the requirement of oxygen being a reactant, but now if the other reactant, or the fuel, is a hydrocarbon, then the products are always carbon dioxide and water. Hydrocarbons come in two slightly different forms. The first one we see here as CXHY, the other is CXHYOZ, with the X, Y, and Z representing a huge range of subscripts. For example, CH4 is methane, or we could have ethane, propane, octane, and waxes have in the vicinity of 24 carbons, and there are many more. If any of them react with oxygen, then the products are carbon dioxide and water. That second type of hydrocarbon you need to be able to identify is just CXHY that has been oxidized to some degree, in other words, has oxygen in the formula, so that its general formula is CXHYOZ, such as formaldehyde, CH2O, or ethyl alcohol, glycerin, glucose, complex carbohydrates, and thousands of others. They are all hydrocarbons that will react with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. So you need to be able to identify a hydrocarbon as having, in general, the formula CXHY or CXHYOZ. Reaction 4 is single replacement, and some textbooks call it single displacement, but it's the same thing. Our example is aluminum reacting with zinc chloride. The identifying feature is an element, usually a metal, reacting with an ionic compound. You may notice from the products that the two metals switch places. This is what our model represents. One element, one compound. The arrow represents the reaction, which is where the metals switch places to become the products. The arrow represents the reaction, which is where the metals switch places to become the products. Notice the neutral aluminum becomes an ion, whereas the zinc ion becomes neutral. This is somewhat simplified. Please see the product prediction video link for single replacement to get a more in-depth view of what is occurring here. For this video, know the identifying feature of one element reacting with one compound, and that is a single replacement. Reaction 5 is double replacement or double displacement in some textbooks, and this is more appropriately referred to as a precipitate reaction in more advanced textbooks. Our example is aqueous magnesium sulfate reacting with aqueous zinc fluoride. Aqueous tells us the compounds are dissolved in water, and this is the identifying feature to look for. Two aqueous ionic compounds on the reactant side. You may have noticed from the products that the two metal ions switch places to become the products, and this is what our model represents. The arrow represents the reaction, the ions switch places, becoming products. The arrow represents the ion switching places and becoming products. The magnesium is now written with the fluoride on the product side, and the zinc is with the sulfate. So we identify double replacement as having two aqueous ionic compound reactants. This is your basic double replacement. Please see the product prediction link to get a much more in-depth view of what is happening so that you can successfully predict products in a double replacement. This has been a Mad Scientist production. See ya!